please hear me. Before anybody convinces you that your problem is a poison or is a satanic attack, I want to show you what is available, which unfortunately most of us in this side of the world are not aware. It is imperative for you to see this young man lying as though dead. But did you know what? This young man had what is called cardiomyopathy, a problem of the heart that of course can be one of the causes of heart failure. The heart wasn't working. This fellow is currently not living with the natural heart me and you have. The heart that he came to the world with was removed and be replaced with an artificial heart. This young man does not have pulse at all. And right now, he is the one more active than most of us will be. Most times, we go to the church, we go to our organization, we give testimonies of our car, we give testimony of appliances, their new building, and some of the technological advanced products you are using. But when it has to do with our health, we go native. We appear to be as though God's responsibility is to make us whole. I want to tell you, that same God giving priority to hell has so much done a lot in our time when it has to do with health matters. And that's one of the things I want to show you right now. Have a look at the experience of this man of God. John Hagee had what is called massive heart attack, a block of the entire vessels of the heart. He was almost gone. He was taken to the hospital and they did something for him. I will explain to you here. He is still living. This same man of God had what is called myasthenia gravis, 2014. He couldn't talk. His mouth couldn't open. No preaching, nothing. He went through a treatment course of neostigmine and other adjuvant treatment for a total of 80 hours, 20 hours every month for 4 months. He's back today, still preaching. What is the fate of our own people? Majority of them are right there in the grave. And what was the autopsy? That it was a poison, it was an attack, and all that. And we have the opportunity today to show you some of the things, not just only happening abroad, but the privileges that is also happening right here in Nigeria, you will be able to get it. Number one, let's look at what happened to the issue of the heart. Listen to me. Heart attack is not something that just happened always, that somebody slumped and died immediately. This can be pockets of blocks, and these things can be reversed. How will it be? If a person has this chest pain, tightening that spread to the jaw, to the back, as Eli explained in one of our videos, this very person can do today what is called angiogram. And if there be a block, what is called angioplasty can be done. And this individual can still be there for the family. In a situation the heart has failed, that very person could be in position to receive what is called biventricular pacemaker. It can be connected to the heart, and this very person, which otherwise we say, let him just be managing. Some people as I'm talking to you right now, some one time healthy, one time energy full individual, today they are on their drugs. They can't do anything. They can't exert a single exertion on them. Life will be going. They are there and all waiting. One day it will be that this very person had to be buried. But we can't continue to be buried like that, because even the cause of burial cannot be compared to a man who is living. If you lose money, you lose something. But if you lose your life, you lose everything. Because when a healthy man is there, he can make more money. But we reverse this trend that we will rather be having pain while we are attending to our health, because we ought to use the money to do something we assume to be better off. That is the wickedness against ourselves. And let me show you something again. Prostate has become a problem of many men. But today, did you know that you can do a prostate surgery without needing to cut the body open? You can do what is called laser prostatectomy. A camera can go through the penis, get right there where the obstruction is, and blow them up. Within 45 minutes, it is over. A professor died of prostate enlargement because somebody said there's a concussion to drink. He will dissolve the prostate. He drank, dissolved his kidney, and today he's late. A man that's supposed to be contributing to the welfare of the society. Now we go further. One of the beautiful promise of God to us is pleasurable longevity. He said, I will satisfy you with long life. But I can